everyone. This is Lisa from Canine Clips. And this is Jessica. And Jessica is one of my senior dogs. She's actually 16 years old. And she's been coming to me for 11 years. She actually comes in every month just to get her face done because it grows in so quickly. And tears and stains quite a lot. So she's been coming to me for a long time, but being a senior dog, she's now become one of my difficult dogs to do just because she does roam around quite a bit. And she does have a little bit of difficulty standing as well. And she is a bit resistant for me to do her face, but she isn't aggressive, but she does move around a lot and will just walk off the table because they get kind of forget what's going on sometimes. I'm just going to give her a number 7 clipper blade. So hopefully you enjoy the video. Get a little closer for you. But she will move around a lot, so I'll try to move the camera along with her. She doesn't have very good vision as well. She has quite a bit of cataracts. And she also has quite a bit of warts on her as well. So you gotta be careful of all these little things. Okay. When the dogs get to this stage, when they're a bit older and move around a lot, I do the best I can. But sometimes I can't get all the areas just because, as you can see, okay. She moves around quite a bit. It's okay. So she's a little bit. Happy day, little girl. Come on. Okay, well, there you go. So some areas may get a little bit missed, but I'm still able to do, I think, a fairly good job, as we will see, without causing them too much stress. These senior guys of mine, hey? But they definitely are a bit more of a challenge, that's for sure. One hand. Okay. Let's move it back, because then you'll be able to get a better view, I think, because she's going to keep moving around for us. As I mentioned before, her owner does come about every month just to get her face done and her nails trimmed. So it gives her a little bit better mobility just so her feet don't get sore and she can see the best she can. On these senior guys, there's always a lot of loose skin. Well, okay.
Okay.
It's always good to check those clipper braids. As usual, so I'm just going to switch it out. I'm actually going to use, switching to number 10, I'm going to do the inside of her leg right now since she's laying. Okay. There we go. Good girl. And also because she's laying here and I don't want to move her, I'm just going to do her foot. So I do these guys a little bit differently, just because of the mobility. So she's already kind of comfortable in this spot, so I just kind of work with her. In her various positions. She's got quite a bit of warts in here as well. Even in between the pads of her feet. So you've got to be careful of those as well. Okay. No, just me. And there are a few warts, I think, on her front leg, her owner said, too, that kind of bleed randomly. So they might bleed when I actually get near them with the clippers or after the bath, because they'll be softened up. And the skin on them isn't very thick. One of them that bled, so I'm just going to put some styptic powder on. Oh, two of them. Oh, and she's... Okay, that... I know, I'm sorry. Oh. There we go. Jessica. Okay, so I'm going to continue on with the clippers. I'm going to switch back to the number 7. Okay. Thank you. Okay. I'm actually going to use the number 10 because there's quite a bit of warts in here that do bleed. So this way there's less likely that I'll nick them when I go to a shorter blade. And since she's up, I'm actually going to continue with the number 7. I'm going to go to the number 10 right now, and I'll go back once she lays down again. Very good grip. And if I were to put a towel down so she would have good grip, she would actually walk off the table. So although it looks uncomfortable for her, it's still the safest. When I do take some of the hair between her feet, it does help. That's why I try to, you can see the back leg there, she has a little bit more grip. And I did the pad. There you go. That's okay. Okay. You got lots of funk there. Switch to the number 10 now. Good girl. Okay. So since she's laying again, I'm going to try to do this foot. Jessica. Alright, got that one done. Good girl. There you go. Two down. Good girl. Okay, she's usually quite difficult with her face. Moves around quite a bit. And you can't get the clippers in there, because she does move around quite a bit and it's heavily matted to get underneath there. I will try, though, with the, you know, should use the 40 blade just because it's cleaner. And I can get deeper in there, but with the moving, she really doesn't like the clippers near her face, so sometimes she lets me and sometimes she doesn't. So although everyone doesn't like my scissors near her face, they're actually, I have better control of them. Although they look a lot scarier on your end, I actually have more control to move them away. Because I don't rely on any restraints, I'm able to kind of be able to feel when the dog moves with my other hand, and that's why I keep it on her at all times. It's okay. But I always get lots of comments about these scissors. I know, it's okay. There's a really thick clump in there. She does have quite a bit of folds of skin as well. I know. There you go. It's okay. But this is always the hardest part on her because she does move around quite a bit. Okay, good girl. Thank you. Okay, it's okay. Okay. It's okay. I'm just gonna raise it up a little bit here. Okay, next tip. A bit of matting in there. There you go. There you go. Good girl. Got that one big mat. Well, I guess it's not a mat, it's more of the tearing. Oh dear. I know, Jessica. It's hard because I can't hold her like the other dogs because she already has a compromised. So she moves around so much. Okay. Well, she's a little squigglier. There. There you go. Good girl. Okay, and she does have a wart. Okay, we're getting there. Jessica. Okay, come on. Just about there. And the Shih Tzus have such big eyes. There you go, good girl. A couple big warts on her head. Well, there, let's see how that is. There. So she has a couple hairs. This is the hard part. Okay. There we go. Okay, good boy. Good girl. It's okay. Okay, so. Just gonna leave her sit like this, or lay like this, and I'll do her ears. Ears are actually quite healthy. Just got quite a bit of hair in them. this one. Okay, go, Jessica, it's okay. Although she's obviously not aggressive, some of my senior dogs have their own challenges, just where they're moving around so much on me. Okay. And although she's been coming for so long, like I said, 11 years, and she's always been a good dog, but just when they get a little older, their temperament changes a little bit, and sometimes they can become aggressive. So if they've never been aggressive before, sometimes they will actually become nippy. But most of them kind of get like Jessica here, where they just lose control of their ability to stand, or they just are always moving around the table and just kind of aren't quite sure what's going on. It's okay, baby. All right, I'm gonna try holding her up here while I do the side and the back leg. We can see those warts on this side a little bit more. There's a few prominent ones here on her leg. Okay. Okay. I know it's okay. One long hair though. She keeps sucking it in her mouth, so I'm gonna try to get that later. I'm just going to get under her belly here as well with the tin, just because there's quite a bit of warts under there. Okay. I'm going to do her bum area just because she's kind of standing there for me. Maybe. She's okay. Gotta do it. There's some warts around your bum as well. Hey girl, it's okay. Anyway, well, while she's kind of laying here, again, it's just kind of working with what you got, depending on how they sit or lay for you. Try to do under her belly here. You're still a fighter. Okay, well, we'll leave it then. Jessica, hey, work with me, baby. What I'm doing right now for you guys is all my difficult dogs, I groom them, like obvious previous to this membership starting up, but after that I've started all the difficult guys, like Jessica here. I'm doing a video for you, and then the next time they come in I'll do another full video, and then that's what I'll put on my channel. So you may actually see Jessica come up again on the full channel. eventually with another groom. She is 16 though, so I never know if they're going to be back. So I'm going to give you guys all the difficult grooms on your channel or membership first. And then if they do come back, I'll be doing another video on them, a full one that'll go on the regular channel. So just so you're aware that you actually may see another video of Jessica come up. And that's the reason why. Just like Kobe, who is on my main channel, who is one of my very anxious dogs. He's already been posted on there. But I will be doing another video of him for you guys when he comes again. Because he's been always a little difficult for me. So that's why you may see the same dog on your feed, on your membership, but also on the regular as well. They're actually going to be two separate videos. I do a little less talking for you guys. And asking you to, you know, sign up and blah, blah, blah. The spiel, so. But if there's something you, like if you do want me to talk more, please let me know in the comments. I'm making these for you guys, so I want you to enjoy them. But if there's anything I can do to make it better for you, let me know. Alright, I'm going to switch to number 10 now. I'm just going to try to do right around her mouth with the 10. There we go. Good girl. Just hopefully I got those ones that she keeps licking in her mouth. Hopefully I've gotten them so that they'll be loose now so they won't actually be hanging in her mouth anymore. But she's still got quite a few there, so. Try to get them this way. Uh-oh. Yeah. Okay, well that helped a little bit. There we go. Okay, good girl. Okay, still gotta do that back leg. I'm gonna try to turn her here. Okay, come on. I was hoping that she'd have more grip with her little feet by now. She wouldn't be so slippery. Okay. Okay, come here. towel down. Let's see if I can get this last leg. Won't stop her from moving, but it may give her the grip she needs to stand up for me. And hopefully I can get her before she tries to go off the table. So my intention is not to duplicate the dogs, unless you would like that. So I know that, you know, there's a few of my dogs that are always difficult. So if you'd like to see them as they come in multiple times, I can do that. And I'll probably do a poll on that as well. So like, I know Jessica will always be a difficult dog, for instance, and Kobe. There's a few actually that are always aggressive towards me or just moving around like Jessica here. So if you'd always like to see their videos, even though it's the same dog, I can do that as well. So I'll be asking you lots of questions, and always, like I said, please comment to let me know, because that it does help me out, because I do take all the comments, because I do want to make this enjoyable for you. Kind of twisted there. I just want to... There. Let me show you there. Just didn't want to twist her too much. She's still... a little bit twisted. I know. A little bit of matting in here. Oh, I had her for a little bit. Good girl. Okay. Let's try to get this up. Always got to be careful because there's warts here. In between our toes as well. So I don't want to nick those. I think there's been two dogs in my 16 years that I haven't been able to groom because they are too aggressive. And well, there was a third one as well, but the owner did help during that grooming process by holding the dog, or trying to hold the dog, but she got bit several times by her own dog. I couldn't put the cone on them because they were so aggressive, like I couldn't even put the cone on. They would just flip up in the air and were just really trying to bite. Like they weren't just, you know, nippy. They were trying to bite me, not the cone. So there was, like I said, a few that do, but very rarely is there one I haven't been able to done, even if they've been known to be aggressive from the other groomers. Okay, I think we're ready. Oh, I didn't do this here. got to do this here, baby. Big wart inside her ear there as well. Jessica. Okay, I know. Okay, there we go. Okay, and we are off to the tub. She doesn't have very much grip in here. Water's pretty dirty from our little girl here. Well, and she's deciding to take a poop. So, girl. It's my senior girl. Oh! Alright, so we're going to take her out of that. Okay, thankfully we got it all rinsed off. I'm just going to let the water drain here. That's the joy of a senior girl. Okay, so I'm just going to take her out right now. Into the towel. Okay, it's okay. And I will clean that up later. Table as well. So because she is a senior, she is prone to having seizures. She hasn't ever had one before when I blow dry. But you never know when they get a little older like this. So if she does start to have a seizure, I will stop the blow drying process. There you go, good girl. Okay, so I'm just gonna take her off the table while I get her headgear ready. Okay, here we go with the blow dryer. Sometimes I go back and blow dry the head a little bit more, but I'm not going to do that with her just because of her age. And I just want to make sure she's as comfortable as possible. There we go. So I'll get the number 7. She can move around a little bit better just because she has a little bit more grip. All that hair gone. I just gotta be careful because there's lots of work to it too. So. Especially after the bath, they get quite a bit softer. Yeah, make sure I don't accidentally nick one. But it can happen just because she's moving around so much too. There we go. So there is our Miss Jessica. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I look forward to make lots more videos for you soon. So take care. We'll see you again.